SPD, a new face for social democratic policies. In the interview, Deputy SPD leader Aydın Özus.
For Özus, the
Ms. Özus, the Social Democrats have had a good year. They won several regional elections, did well in others. They seem to have got over their general election defeat in 2009. Is the SPD back on track?
Well, we just had an excellent party conference. We needed to get a feeling for what was happening at the grassroots level. 2 years ago, we never would have expected to be where we are now. That is, on a very positive path. We managed to shake off that heavy defeat quickly. Now we're in an excellent position, and we have a lot of personalities and a lot to offer. I think people have realized that now, both within the party and among the public, so we're in good shape.
Ich glaube, das zeigt sich eben auch nach außen, wie auch nach innen. Also da sind wir sehr guter Dinge.
Have the Social Democrats regained their confidence?
Ja, man merkt es schon.
Yes, you can really tell that the party has pulled itself together. Suffering a defeat can impact in all sorts of ways. We made the best of the situation, picked ourselves up again, analyzed our mistakes, and then started looking to the future, to work for the good of the country and for our party, of course. And that's been successful. And you can really feel that it's not a top-down process, but comes from all levels, right down to the local party associations.
Has the SPD gone back to looking after the interests of the little man, working men and women?
I don't think the SPD ever stopped doing that. But the party has made mistakes in the past. And we've had to admit that we've sometimes failed to communicate to people what our policies are about. Any major party has to be able to communicate properly with the electorate so they can judge its actions. I think that's been the secret of our success, facing up to those failings and doing something about them, rather than just coasting along.
Wo sind Kommunikationsstörungen und die aufzuarbeiten, und das scheint wunderbar gelungen.
A little over a year ago, there was a book here in Germany that caused quite a stir. The title can be translated as Germany Does Away With Itself, and it was written by Thilo Sarrazin, an SPD politician, former finance minister in Berlin's regional government, and former board member at the Bundesbank. The main thrust of the book was that Muslim immigrants contribute nothing to our economic prosperity or to Germany's cultural life. Were you offended when you read that book?
Es gibt ja auch andere, die in eine ähnliche Richtung gehen, aber nicht ganz so gut.
There are many books with that kind of content, but most don't receive the same amount of hype. I do read them carefully to see what's actually behind them. And a lot of hurtful things have been said that have hurt a lot of people. Also, the tone of the debate has sometimes been hurtful. I don't think the book you mentioned has been helpful in the debate about how different parts of society can coexist and with the problems and failings in that area. You can analyze the situation in schools, in the workplace, in society as a whole, and identify issues without having to discriminate against certain religious or so-called ethnic communities. That has to be the way forward for Germany.
In der Weise diskriminieren zu müssen. Und ich glaube, das muss unser Weg auch sein als Deutschland.
Your party had two main reactions to the book. First, to try unsuccessfully to expel its author from its ranks, and second, to vote a, if you'll excuse the phrase, token foreigner onto its party executive. That's you. You are the new deputy party leader of the SPD. Does that bother you?
Hat sie das geärgert?
Überhaupt nicht. Auch wir brauchen Namen.
Not at all. We need to profile names and faces that might appear foreign or just different to wider society. And I was asked if I was interested in the post. I considered carefully whether it would be a good thing to go down that path. And I believe it was right. It sends a signal to the younger generation that having a name like Özus or Özkan doesn't mean your prospects are limited and that our society will accept you if you make the effort and identify with that society. I think that's a very important message. And it's good for other parts of society to see that some stereotypes, like that of the ardently religious Muslim, are not always true. Our society has changed a lot in the past few decades. And the ultimate aim is for everyone to be able to feel part of it, whatever their name or background. And I think that's the right way to go.
I've noticed that many of these politicians with their meteoric careers, like your own, specialize in integration policy. Why shouldn't they be responsible for social policy or labor, foreign or defense policy? Of course, their abilities cover a broad spectrum, but they tend to get pigeonholed.
That hasn't really been the case with me. But it's true, I always advise those young politicians to avoid focusing exclusively on integration policy. I believe the normality we're hoping to achieve includes having such people in all political areas. But my case is a little different. In my professional career, I spent many years working in integration policy, and I've actively pursued it as a field. I don't see it as a career move. I just have the feeling of belonging to the generation that has to keep opening doors and making things change. And that's my priority. I will always do that whenever I think it's necessary and appropriate.
You were born in Hamburg. In other countries, that would automatically make you a native. But are you German? A German from an immigrant background? A German with Turkish family roots? How do you define yourself?
Of course I'm German, but not by birth. At the time I was born, naturalization was simply not on the cards. A lot of people forget that. That's something that's come about in the past few years. It was taken for granted that I was a foreigner. Right through school, I was always the foreign girl. But at some point, I decided to take German citizenship. I was the first of my friends to do it, and it was seen as unusual.
By your parents, too?
My parents were very much in favor of it. They always thought it was strange that we were born here, but still counted as foreigners. Not for themselves. They grew up in Istanbul with Turkish values. But they always told us that this was where we belonged, and so we should take German citizenship. What you have to keep in mind is that I have my parents and my background, but I was born here, grew up here, and so I'm German. Being German doesn't just mean coming from a long line of German ancestors. There is a new definition of being German, and we all have to become sensitive to that.
The German president said recently that Islam is a part of Germany. Did it feel liberating to hear that?
Well, it was a shame that the interior minister felt the need to contradict him straight away. I think there's no question these days that Islam is part of Germany. Although it's still open to debate in what way it's part of Germany. I was just speaking to an elderly lady on the phone, and she said that of course Muslims are part of Germany, but Islam is not. That's something I just can't understand. I do think there is a fear of the unknown, and many people were initially shocked to hear someone say Islam is part of Germany because of all the things and images they connect with Islam, like images of terrorist attacks. I think we need to work on that and think about whether it is right to be afraid of such an abstract thing as a religion or the religious community connected to it. We have some way to go on that, and at least the president managed to open up the debate. That was a good thing.
Ms. Özöz, thank you.
Ich danke Ihnen.